Hi guys, it's Onella, and with me today I have Bijan, radio killer. I always say a road killer, I don't know why.
It was made for the road, but it's okay. Radio too.
You're fast.
And you're listening faster, that's very good.
Okay, so I'm seeing you're wearing your brand. I'm not sure, one of them, I'm not sure if I can say it, but I will anyhow.
King-ish.
It's spelled King.
Yeah, but we say King-ish. Then you're on TV.
King.
Right.
Can you tell me a little bit about it?
Actually, just to make it brief, a king does what he wants. I had several lines over the years, and my team just decided that it was time to do something, not arrogant, but something that will let them know that we don't necessarily follow trends or we are not looking for approval. So if a king do we want, we say king shit. Who can tell me no?
And your mission statement in life as well.
Must bus.
B-U-S-S.
Mm-hmm. M-U-S-T. B-U-S-S.
Why?
Why?
Because when I hear that, I think of something.
Yeah. Actually, a lot of people get misguided, but it's not a problem because in life we all must bust, or me or you wouldn't be here. But, however, I believe that at some point every artist is supposed to find a niche that they could grab to. So, for instance, me personally, I just believe that everybody should find what they want and love in life and basically push towards it. With that mindset and that frame of mind, is only one thing that came about for me, and personally that was must bust, meaning that I have to make it in life and nothing will stop me. A lot of people try to, over the years, change it to done bust, saying that I bust already, but as far as I'm concerned, even if I was the biggest artist in the world right now, I still must bust, because after you bust, you gotta keep busting in order to remain relevant and live. Why not you just die off like a leaf?
But recently, you did bus with the R&R Rhythm.
To an extent, yes.
Yes, it was. You had a very good song, and I mean, it got around in Trinidad. The response was, I think it was good.
We had to work for it, though. I mean, like, big up Dougie Slaughter, big up Bungie Garland, the General, because between two of them and Frank Management. Don't let me forget anybody. We actually did a lot of work, because when I initially got here, because I got here a little later than I was supposed to, because I had a lot of work going on in Barbados. So I was trying to finish up everything before I come out for Carnival. I was here for like the whole 2 months, January and February. Mm-hmm. So by the time I got here, it had already released. The interviews had went for most major stations. So to everybody, it was like with the rhythm set. But then it was like, I show up. And pop up and be like, who's this person here? Like, you know what I mean? Who don't know? Is like, but then when they see that I was moving around with the team and we started to do interviews and performing everywhere, it was like, wow, you officially on the rhythm? Because people thought that I just got the rhythm and jump on and put a song. People like they didn't realize that I originally was on the rhythm. Yeah.
Well, I mean, he might have drilled you all, but I mean, the results were good.
Of course it was. I mean, like...
That was the hottest rhythm. I wanted to jump on it, but nobody would record me.
You want to jump to it? You jump? This year?
No, I've never played Mass. I was actually going to ask you.
So you ain't jump on the beat and you ain't jump either?
No, I mean, I was in Fets and I whined it. I don't jump, I whine.
So next year we can make a promise and you going on the road? You going on the road next year with me?
Yeah.
Yeah? Yeah?
Right.
All right, everybody here heard it, right? Is a promise? Right.
Mm-hmm. So you've played Mars and Trinidad before?
From an artist's point of view, I don't really play as in to buy a costume and go in the crowd.
Because you get free costumes.
No, I don't. I'd be on the track singing and entertaining people. However, after I'm finished working, I will get them and I will go and frolic and dance and enjoy myself around people.
Okay, so... Be honest, do you prefer Crop Over or Trinidad Carnival?
No, I can smartly answer that without getting in trouble. There's different elements to it. Honestly, right? Because like 10 months of the year in Barbados. Mm-hmm. I am a dancehall and reggae artist. That's what I actually known as. That's where I actually made my bread for the last couple of years of my life. And that's where my majority of my popularity stem from. However, I find that the reason why I wasn't getting the major influence that I wanted when I did my soca music in Barbados is because, let me say, if you're doing something like dancehall and reggae, it's going to influence anything else you do. Mm-hmm. So my soca was dancehall and reggae fused. Then when I realized, in order for me to really get the essence of soca, I need to be in that setting and frame of mind. Hence why I realized, you know what? You got a little fan base in Trinidad to a certain extent. You got a couple of friends and thing. Trinidad is the move. So like 6 years ago, I just took up some money and think Trinidad for like a month. And it was like scoping out the scene, see what's going on. Where I could, I tried to inject my music, but I wasn't really pushing it to that level. The next year I come, music again. You network, you link with a couple of people, and it rolled on year and year to like year before I end up linking with Chocolate City. Mm-hmm. I perform on the truck. I went to a couple of things. I get a little outing. That was nice. Last year I was moving with Millionaire Family and them in the south. All these people are still my brothers. Me and everybody good. So I ain't a fallout or anything. Because I realize one thing. As much as people talk, Trini's actually wants you about something in life. Positive Trinidadians always embrace it. And they're willing to help. And that's one thing that I would accredit. Not to get off topic, but I just had to say that. So for Carnival, I find it important because it helps me to enhance my soca character when it comes to crop over. So Carnival actually helps my crop over. So it's important, not one and not the next. Carnival got its own place in my heart, crop over got its own place. But I will be honest and say, when it comes to turning up, Trinis is turn up from jump. I love that. Barbadians, they like wind up doors, you gotta warm them up. So they will come out, I mean the road they be thing and that type of thing, but you see when Trinis come out, from the time they touch the street, we drinking, we partying, we
drinking. But they drinking from since they home.
I've been drinking the whole day. You see, that was for them, because they know what's going on. Trinidad is the bomb. Carnival is the bomb. Propover is the bomb too.
Not Carnival, nicer though.
You got a plug for your country. I can't leave out mine, but I can't discredit yours.
Well, I have to try. Okay, so hear this. We're doing Crop Over, and we're doing Trinidad Carnival.
Yes, that was the promise you made, so you have to stick by it. And I hold people to their
promise. I'll stick by it.
Right.
Okay, so for Come Over on the Grinders Rhythm, that is with Doggy Slaughter again.
Super producer, the genius of 2016.
I think after Arna Rhythm, he's like one of the best.
Y'all ain't heard nothing yet, trust me. He got rhythms up in there that can shake the place. He ready for 2017 too. I wasn't supposed to say that, but I did. So Trini Singh get exclusive. I also got a project in Masterpiece right now. And that's with my brother Lyrical, or as y'all know, Lyrical Martin. So they got Lyrical and the whole of the family in Attic in America. I got one or two other projects coming up for Crop Over, and we actually start working on Carnival already, so it's looking very good.
So in a nutshell, Bajan Radio Killer is single with no woman to nag him. Look, she could see this. Lord, she could see this, be honest.
Rich, when you seen trying to advertise me or something, because here we know, if
I can pimp you out if you want me to.
No, here we know, if you're trying to pimp me, we got to find somebody that could cut clean, they got to go a job, so I just joking.
He not joking, I don't know why he's saying that.
So what happened, you can fill the space then?
Maybe.
You could cook?
Yes.
Just checking. Hello.
Not only curry, oh my God, that was racist. I wish we could like flip the camera too. Okay, we're gonna be enough.
Yeah, I know, right? Jamali will edit. It's okay.
Yeah. We just edit out. We just edited out when everything that was just said.
They was drinking, they were happy. Yeah, they didn't know Yans was on the ends, right? That's all right. But he's supposed to back you up. He's supposed to back you up. That's all right. Good. But
they have like a love-hate relationship. I know you can't see her, but
oh,
they do.
My sister, so it'd be cool. Yeah.
Okay, so your alias name is Bajan Radio Killer. I say Road Killer. Yeah. Everybody does. Uh-huh. And your artist name is Phantom Dundeel.
Yeah.
How?
All right, so what happened is 7 years ago, because I started recording about 8 years ago, mm-hmm. after about a year, we realized I had projects, but no name. So, because I really wasn't studying the artist life. I just loved music to the point and expressing myself. So writing lyrics and recording was part of my personal getting things off my chest. You know, somebody else would get vexed and get shocked. Somebody would call the girlfriends and... me, I was the... write my things, put them out. But when the producer tell me, but you gonna get an artist name, I was like, I can name myself Fans. That's who I doing it for, whoever can relate to me. So he was like, that can't work, too short, too corny. So I was like, well, we can name me Tom, Dick and Harry. He was like, how about we name you Phantom? And I was studying it, and I said, so we can use Phantom with the F-A-N-T-O-M instead of the P-H, because people often, when they hear Phantom, they think of P-H, which is the cartoon character with the purple tights. That ain't me, right? Nah. So, I was moving with Phantom, and then after a couple months, like, I left that studio I was in, and I went to a different studio. And the first day there, the guy, the engineer, told me, we want a freestyle from you. They just wanted to see where my talent scored. So in the freestyle, I told them, no matter what happened, I can always keep it real. And at the end of the day, they call me the Dundeel. So everybody was like, Dundeel. And they just start calling me Dundeel. So I went from having one name to having a first and a last name, Phantom Dundeel. After a couple of years, I realized that people stopped calling me Phantom and start calling me Dundeel by itself. So, seeing that you got Dundeel, the producer overseas, which is actually one of my brethren, because he's following me and everything of his messages and things, and a couple other people that trying to grab the name, like Main Deal and all type of things. So, I was like, you know what? I got discovered. And the day I went to another studio, and the guy was like, at the beginning of your song, you normally said the Dundeel. You got a funny saying that, and I was like, you can come, just laugh it. And we was doing the song. And when we get to the beginning, I was like, the Bajan Radio Killer. And he was like, what's that? I was like, I don't know, it sound bad. And he was like, no. And then we start to move with it, because, or the way how my brain works, a lot of things come on instinct. But then sometimes you have to sit down and figure out why something came to light. So after sitting down, I realized it was like, my struggle all the time was trying to get a place for myself musically on the radio. Obviously, that's the aim of most artists, because when you put music in the street, you hope that it comes to the level of the radio and then get over to the commercial side. Now, for the fact that I was one of the most played artists in Barbados for a couple of years now, probably from the time I came out until now, I happened to remain relevant. So it just fall in. And then what really made me stick with the Radio Killer was when I realized that some people got offended by it. Not necessarily in a big enough position to do me anything, but They took the name Radio Killer as offensive, because to them it sounded as if I was bragging, because I was played a lot and I never had to pay for play, them type of things. But at the end of the day, it was something that clicked to me, so I just stuck with it, and people now love it. I mean, apart from Trinidad, everybody's called me the Bajan Road Killer. So I guess they see me on the road so much in Trinidad, they say, you know what? In radio, it's Road Killer. So it's the Road Killer in Trinidad, but it's the Radio Killer in Barbados and everywhere else. Just like you are Nelly Smelly.